The smallest marine mammal in the ocean is still the world's biggest weasel, closely related to minks, badgers, and wolverines. Sea otters outweigh them all. And the largest marine mammal, the blue whale, is the biggest animal that the planet has ever seen. Bigger than even the biggest dinosaur. The tongue of a blue whale alone weighs more than a full-grown elephant. And their hearts are roughly the size of an American bison, pumping about 227 liters of blood with every single beat. Even the world's largest bear is a marine mammal. But why? What is it about living in the ocean that creates such behemoths? I'm KP, a marine biologist who specializes in marine mammals like sea otters and walruses. For a long time, scientists believed that animals in the ocean evolved to be so massive because of the lack of gravity. The thinking went that the buoyancy of the water and the ability to float made it so that these animals didn't have to support their weight on legs and bones. Just take a look at my favorite animal of all time, the walrus. Walruses are incredibly graceful and agile swimmers. They can dive up to 300 feet or around 90 meters, and they can reach speeds of 22 miles an hour if they're really trying, or 30 kilometers an hour for my metric friends. Although their average swimming speed is around 5 miles per hour or 7 kilometers an hour. But on land, well, watch my boy Balzac haul out of the water. You can see the effect gravity has on his bulk and the effort it takes just to lumber around. He quite literally weighs a ton, like an actual ton. Roughly 2,100 pounds right now, almost 1,000 kilos. And as big as he looks, Balzac is still growing. He's going to end up being around twice this size. Adult male walruses average around 4,000 to 5,000 pounds. That's the average weight of a modern sedan or 40 bags of cement. At first glance, the theory that the lack of gravity is why marine mammals in the ocean become so big seems pretty plausible. Just imagine lugging around 40 bags of cement every single day. However, a new study by Stanford Center for Earth, Energy, and Environmental Sciences proved that the exact opposite is true. It's not that living in the ocean allows you to be a big animal, it's that you need to be a big animal to live in the ocean. Or as the authors put it, these animals are big for very specific reasons. It's not that they can be big, it's that they must be big. And the reason is body heat. The ocean is a cold place, much colder than the average body temperature of a mammal. And heat loss happens 27 times faster in water than in air. The bigger you are, the more heat you retain. And when you're small, you lose heat back into the water so fast that the only way to generate enough heat to stay warm is to eat. A lot.
Nice catch.
Sea otters are a great example since they're the smallest marine mammal and the only one without a layer of blubber. While they do have the densest fur coat in the animal kingdom, it isn't enough. Instead, they generate a massive amount of body heat just by eating. Their metabolic rate at rest is about 3 times higher than that of a similar-sized land mammal. And every single day, a sea otter will eat roughly a quarter of their body weight. So a 40-pound sea otter will eat 10 pounds of clams, crabs, and mussels in just one day. Now let's compare that to a human. We only need to eat about 2% of our body mass every single day. To eat as much as a sea otter, a 150-pound person would need to eat almost 40 quarter-pound cheeseburgers every single day. Blue whales tip the scale at over 300,000 pounds, and if they needed to eat as much as a sea otter in order to stay warm,
That would be 75,000 pounds of food in a day. There is simply no way for them to eat that much. So not only have they evolved into massive creatures that trap body heat, but they also developed a different feeding strategy. Instead of teeth, baleen whales have plates of keratin from which they get their name. These baleen plates are essentially filters inside their mouths. When they feed, a baleen whale opens its mouth to take in water and then pushes the water out, leaving the krill or whatever item they are after inside.
And another feeding method that baleen whales have adapted to conserve their energy is to simply rest at the surface of the water with their mouths open.
Fish will actually swim inside, seemingly mistaking it for a safe haven from predators. This allows baleen whales to expend significantly less energy on feeding than their toothed counterparts, like orcas and sperm whales. And it allows them to grow significantly larger. The sperm whale seems to be the largest you can get without a new adaptation, the authors of the Stanford Earth Study said. The only way to get as big as a baleen whale is to completely change how you're eating. Because of their massive size and their efficient ways of feeding, blue whales only need to eat about 8,500 pounds of krill a day,
which is still the weight equivalent of a full-grown male hippo. And this unfortunately means that these whales are ingesting an enormous amount of pollutants. Done a video about that, you can find it right up here. Every day, a blue whale eats 10 million pieces of microplastic. That's a 60-inch flat screen TV's worth of plastic every single day.
The researchers behind this study are now working on whether or not their methods and findings can explain body size distribution in other animal groups. Because body size is one of the most important traits when looking at animals. If you're going to measure one thing in an animal, it should be body size, because that one thing is related to so many others. If you know how big an animal is, you probably know something about how it moves and its metabolic rate.
It's this information that government entities use when designing protections for these giant marine mammals. And I'm speaking from experience as somebody who participated in the metabolic research for juvenile walruses, and you can find a link to that video right up here. You can see actual footage of me working with those walruses around the 5-minute mark. Let me know if you have any comments down in the section below, and like and subscribe if you liked the video. I'll catch you next time.
Make sure your phone is on sound. I can just see this happening.
However, a new study by Stanford's Center for Earth, Energy, and Environmental Sciences proved that the exact opposite is true.